Okay. Yo, Carol, Forky. Thank you both for showing up so early. What's up? Hope you're both well today. Sup, sup indeed. Can we lurking for now? Cooking? All right. What are you cooking? Are you gonna try making some mashed potatoes? Let's go. Mashed potatoes are one of the best foods in the world. So, I hope they're delicious anyways. That is my girlfriend's favorite food, smashed potatoes. Whenever we have like a special occasion, whenever I make like a special occasion dinner, it's always mashed potatoes and something. I like putting cheese in them and some garlic. Some garlicky, cheesy mashed potatoes. Can't beat it. With like a nice, like a light gravy. Long weekend hype, let's go. Oh, is that why you're able to actually join us for Parks and Rec tomorrow, Forky? Because you got a long weekend? Or I guess everyone has a long weekend. It's Easter. Forgot. Easter's one I always forget about. I guess it's Good Friday tomorrow. Means it's medium Thursday today. But also thank you for the good luck on the games, Carol, if you can hear me.
That's it.
Still at the
I've come up
bottom.
with a new recipe.
Yo, Dragon Die. Great to see you. I hope you're having a good Thursday. Yeah, you get to join just for the start of season two as well. So you got to skip all of season one. You're having a medium Thursday on the medium Thursday? Ah, well, I was hoping that your Thursday was better than medium, but understandable. Just dental crap. Ah, fair enough, yeah. Dental crap is annoying. Glad you're otherwise fine, at least. Carol's making mashed potatoes. You couldn't be any less than medium, even if you were having a limb amputated. Hey, fair enough. Yeah. Homemade mashed potatoes, like I was saying, probably one of the best foods in the world. Also, a very easy vegan thing, right? Delicious and vegan. Think you're feeling up to stream later tonight? Well, that's good. Yeah, that's definitely good. Yeah, how much more do you have to do on Battleground or not Battlegrounds on Baldur's Gate? Hearthstone's Battlegrounds 3. Are you in Act 3 now? At least 10 more streams, but maybe more like 15. Oh damn. I mean, you're kind of in the home stretch now though. It's such a dense game. It's a little bit hard for me to like focus on, like as a viewer. Just because, like, if you're not following everything, I feel like it's so easy to get lost. But yeah, one day I'd like to dive in again. I hear nothing but glowing praise from everyone. So I'm supposed to stream entirely in the wizard shop, really? Just like shopping, or is there like a whole? Is there like a whole like dungeon or something? I think we're going Sinbad here. Toy Dino maybe safer, but Sinbad's certainly more fun. These are the two that I'm looking at the most, anyways. And I'm gonna go with Sinbad. And I think we're gonna go with an owl start. We will not be locking this. He deserves to be thrown off his tower. Oh, is the wizard shop guy not cool? It's a big shop with a mini dungeon and like three quests. Nice. That's dense. Like I said, real dense game. I got backbreakered or whatever the pro wrestling move is called. For real. Not pro wrestling. Okay. I think a backbreaker is a pro wrestling move. I don't really want any of this. I can't roll though. Just this. No, I guess it's the Dorfy. It's just more stats. I don't love it though. Lift them over the head and then spine on the knee. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that is a backbreaker. Oh, hey, it's Horse Thief. He's such a dick. This guy you look forward to murdering the most. Okay. How many playthroughs are you deep, Forky? I know you were on Baldur's Gate pretty early. I'm definitely casting this spell. I think I'm selling this item. Or maybe I keep the item and sell the Dwarfy since it's only a 1-1. No.
I think we ought to throw those bars out and eat ham and mayonnaise sandwiches.
That's not a good idea.
Ham and
I don't
mayonnaise.
Love this, but that's what
ham
we're doing.
No.
Ham and mayonnaise. Ham and
yo, Kivial. How's it going? I hope you're having a good Thursday. Yeah, we were not strong enough. That's a pretty big board on that side already as well. I probably just want the pair of threes, but at the same time, like, I really want to cast a spell. But, like, how do I pass up the pair of threes as Sinbad, right? Free spell? No. Do I want this? I mean, I guess it could be, like, double ice ring. I think I have to take it, right? Not feeling in the best position here. I feel like we're going to take damage this turn. That's a pretty large angel. Okay, fortunately the rest of their board, they didn't take anything that was very large at all, so that's helpful for us. All right, double ice ring. Ooh, double farming tools is also really nice. But I think with the owl, we got a double ice ring. I mean, double ice ring, we got to do this too, I think. Like, if I was ever going to take the yellow bark, it's going to be a double ice rink yellow bark. they also cast an ice ring. So putting stats here actually, I think ended up being good. Get a lot of attack out of it though. What do you think, Chameleon? Chameleon in front of the shield page goes up to 4 power. It's not so great, I guess. Could do double egg. I don't love egg as a pair though, if I want to actually hit treasures. You only get 2, but it is large. Don't think we take another apprentice owl. It is a 3-3 though. Just not much. Well, it'd technically be a 5-3. Just taking it. I need to decide though. Roll. Alright, punished. One more roll. It's gonna take just a random ranged character here. Oh, we got Kleck on Fisher King as well. Oh man, this is a stacked lobby. Unfortunate, pretty bad run out. Gain a little bit of health, I think. Yeah, I'll take a wizard hat. I want to sell something here. I think I might have to sell the shield page for the fairy. So I want to buy this fairy, I think. Get the attack scaling, hopefully it goes here. They are of course keeping pace with their own owl here. It's just picking up ranged characters from here is probably where we want to be. Like, I'm not sure if we're even getting spell treasures fast enough to, like, be mages. Another earthquake, sure. Everyone's earthquaking us here. And yeah, bad run out. I mean, the combat spells against us is not helping. Gain one health. Okay, one hero attack. Is that worth the mana? Go Romeo Juliet. Not like fantastic or anything. But we need something. That or hold off for a pair. We do want to fill up our treasure slots, but I don't even know if this is better. Like, only very slightly better than this. Like, this would actually keep growing. I don't know. Maybe a mistake. Not worth the investment. Double Radiant Fairy that are much bigger. Alright, at least our owl survived long enough to trade there. Picking both pairs, it might not be good, but that's what's happening. Kick. I can't do this, I don't think. Twist. What do we twist, though? Don't think it can be Hansel. Hansel's getting too many stats. I mean, whatever we turn it to, it's going to be a have a bunch of extra power. So, if it's a ranged character, that could be really good. But it's getting a lot from our hero power. Maybe it's just this. Not great, but it's a spell cast anyways. All right, we need to hit these triples. Makes my hands a little bit better. Horsleaf has taken, or just maybe gone to look at a, or just chosen to look at a 5, or a 5 shop. Because I don't think you lose this. Okay, apparently he does lose this, so. Loses exactly by probably exactly as much as he wanted to, so. That was a pretty calculated lose the fight there. I don't think I'm ever like going for hero attack, right? Like, I don't take this Watson. And we'll take a Narc, I guess. Gretel. I could take XP. What does that look like? Are we out of yellow bark for it? No, I think I just need to hit treasures, but things are not cooperating here. Apparently they got to become Sinbad as well. At least they don't have stat treasures yet. At least the beginning of last turn they didn't. Not losing fights, that's important. Symbol, Hero Helix. How good is Hero Helix here? It would give us another ice ring. Symbol would let me take this Hellhound. That would be pretty big right away. Could take Shard, the XP, and just go to 6 right away and try and hit a level 6. Okay, Symbol. I don't feel good about it, though. If we find, I mean, if we were to find the high demon, that would have been a lot of stats. Do I just take another three pair? Oh, that's a ghost fight. Well, that was a waste. Treasures go before spells for some reason. Alright, we're done with yellow bark now. Ooh, core fusion. Could core fusion the owl onto the fairy? That doesn't feel, it feels a little bit too temporary. It's tempting, but. Actually, do I even want this? Not really. Well, Crystal Sage, is this even worth it? At this point, we've got one mage. We're not doing it. We're not doing the spell thing. It's not happening. Take another one of these. Carol's just sauteing some onions. Just onions? Oh. I mean, onions do smell good. Scissors and talisman. Okay, well, somebody's trying not to die, but still did, unfortunately for them. Haven't even put garlic in yet. No, damn. Must be some great onions. Core fusion would be great if we could find, like, an angelic commander, but we need to find that first. Think of Angelic Commander. Horse Thief has hit drumroll and has symbol and has commander. So. I tried using cornstarch to thicken the mashed potatoes. No, I've never had an issue with the mashed potatoes getting too thin. But that. I used cornstarch to thicken gravy. So that's interesting for sure. Am I just taking scam here? I suppose so. Man, we've had these three pairs for so long, and it's just like. No help from the shops whatsoever, unfortunately. Hmm. Oh, I didn't get the lock. I was too slow. I wanted to lock the wolf there, though. Thinking of using vegan cream instead of milk. Plant milk is bad for cooking, is it? I've never used it, so... That could certainly be true. And we finally find a three pair, or three triple. A little bit too little too late, probably. We do get Chrono Crystal, though, so we're not dead, at least. That is something. Kleck's doing some support stuff. Just like good boy supports. Don't think we're a good boy. We're in a spot for a good boy. Could Titan's Flowers the Apprentice Owl? Like, I'm not... I don't know. I mean, there's obviously other stuff I can get, but, like, it's almost worth it. No, it's probably not. Overall, probably just not worth it. I need to triple these. I need to triple the demon, like, real bad. Okay, we hit the good boy. It's not bad. Not game-breaking or anything. Alright. Kleck just didn't hit any treasures, it looks like. Looks like he was struggling just as much as we were, if not worse. So, I mean, that works out for us. Okay. That is spicy. Now we just need core fusion one time. Yeah, it'll buff anything on your board, T-Gun. Also, hope you're having a good Thursday, T-Gun. Welcome. Crescent Blade. I think I like Crescent Blade here. I mean, still kind of small, but we need to. I think, yeah, I think this actually is fine. Because we get three from this. So 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 8, 9-ish. Ten. Yeah, basically we really need the core fusion. That's like, that's gonna be probably what probably make or break. I mean, I don't even know if it'll be enough, but wait, do they really get the pig on? On my, okay, of course they did. I guess it'd be weirder if they didn't. All right, core fusion. Here we go. No core fusion. I mean, I want to go first, so I guess I can't cast this because we need the mana just in case we find the core fusion. Is this even worth it? I don't know if I should even bother with another Archangel. Like, reviving these don't matter unless we get them big. I mean, I can Wolfbait. What do I even wolf, though? Do I just go too deep on this? Or I guess this isn't an aura. I don't know why I keep thinking this is an aura. It's not even that good to have. I guess we need to find an Archdemon. I think I still fire this off on something. Maybe just on this. And then if we find a third one. If we find a third one, then we get to combine them, of course. I mean, the billions of stars are just a little bit too much, I think. Again, we can transition to scam, like, right now. Because I think we've seen all our core fusions, unfortunately. I think we're still gonna look for it though. Try and retain a little bit of optimism. I could change heroes. I don't think I want to though. Okay, how do we switch up our board here? Like, this probably doesn't matter. I guess we don't play the second one. Although with the Crescent Blade, it is kind of good still. Go like this, maybe? I think I want the high demon stats on all the summons if I can. It does make our Crescent Blade kind of useless, unfortunately. Just fire off the combat spell. We might not see it again. See a core fusion, I might be kind of sad because we could still like go back to the angel board, but yeah, I don't think it's gonna happen. Just two francs, I guess. Are we just in francs instead of apprentice owl now? Apprentice owl pretty big though. No, I think so. I think this is how we play it. And we just pray. We'll pray to this the scam RNG lords or whatever. The gods of scam RNG. Probably hit ready, I guess. I mean, this positioning might be pretty awful. I think we're in good position though with these hits. Maybe. If we go left, oh yeah, we're good. Fortunately, we don't knock them out. Ascension? No, I don't think so. One health doesn't help. Lucky coin, sure. Do like succubus. I think we're set up better against Horse Thief Stars here though. Scarf is just battle song, unfortunately. Scarf is actually kind of interesting too though. That doubles our high demon buff. Actually, you know what? That's probably it. Another franc? I don't think I lock another franc. Me too, Dragon Die. Easily one of my top three favorite bands. It's one of those that I can put on any one of their albums and just enjoy the whole thing. That's annoying. So is that. I guess kind of expected, but still. Yeah, of course. Getting third is a little unfortunate. I mean, just in general. I posted that. Lara posted that on Discord. Yeah, I mean, Horse Thief he just hit the drum roll and kind of high rolled once again. What can you do? Three MMR feels pretty bad, though. Our 3MMR did put us above Kleck because I think he got 5th in that lobby. So we went up one spot anyways. Thanks to that MMR difference. Yeah, basically getting our archdemon scammed there was kind of well, I attacked with the flying item. Kinda hosed us. So, like, I guess like high demon is probably the thing that we were happiest to lose there. I don't know, it just came up short in a few different areas is all. I don't know if Symbol of Unity even really paid off. That's probably a bad pick, just itself. We had to have a lot of things go right to really get there with Angelic Commander. I mean, we needed to find the core fusion. We just saw them too early, and then they didn't show up late. So how are we getting, I guess, are people just like not playing? Like, we're getting 3-minute queues the day before the tournament? I mean, pretty easy Fisher King for me, I think. I don't mind Guan Yin. I like Merlin, too. Merlin, I think Merlin's a little bit risky, though. Because, like there's certainly high roll potential, but... A zero hero attack can be a little suspect. Do we start Sprout or Owl? Sprout guaranteed gets stats. I like Owl though. Owl plus spell plus item next turn. I don't mind taking Sprout on turn one still though. I probably wouldn't start taking them before then, though. Metaphors with the spiked owl. Oh my god, I'm an idiot. I'm an actual moron. I didn't take the sword. That was, oh my god. Hey, what's up, love? Doing all right. How are you today? Having a weird day? Oh no. Yeah, if I took that sword, we tie that fight. That's frustrating. I lost HP for that. So annoying. I'm so annoyed with myself. What's weird about your day? God, you went to grade school with Hit on you, and you had to tell him. Oh man, that is weird. That's awkward. Always. Sorry that happened. Alright, here we go. Bottled ship? Maybe? Nope. Is that Merlin's tower ever? Yeah, no, fair enough. That's... I I don't even know if, I guess it's Merlin's Tower, and then we try and like get ourselves a double XP. I would like to cast a spell, but I don't think I'm gonna be able to. I think I just take this. Yeah, it's always awkward how to handle those situations, for sure. One spell here. I should start trying to cast multiple spells, right? I would like to cast combat spell just to make sure we're staying healthy. Already lost one fight just due to negligence. But also then I'll have less than 6 gold and then I can't buy 2 threes. Gonna roll. Yo, Fiesta, thank you so much for the raid. Hope you had a great stream. Sucks. This is not good. But this is what we're doing. The shops are not great. Yeah, how are your games today, Fiesta? Alright, love, talk to you soon or later. Fun stream, not best results, but fun chat. Oh, well, that's good. Last game you got knocked out fast, 2 early lamps. But 2 people with lamps early? Oh, that's... yeah, that's rough. There was a cat today. All right, what's up, MW? Yeah, for the most part. I think, was this only game 2? Yeah, we're only on game 2. We had a sort of disappointing third in the last one. I mean, I guess it wasn't like supremely disappointing, but we just kind of got beat up by Horse Thief is all. I'm gonna take this pair. I really want to cast a spell. I want to be ready for a double XP spell. Oh man, the power on our backline actually kind of hosed us. Well, at least we get the tie here. Yeah, for sure. He does, Horse Thief definitely, does high roll once in a while. In my last stream, he high rolled pretty hard on me as well. So it's like 2 days in a row. I guess it's just Wishing Fountain here. I'm on 4, so I don't really want to take this. Like, it's fine with this, though. At least he won't do it in the tournament. I mean, true, I guess, yeah, he's not, he's gonna be casting the tournament. I don't really love Grim Twisting, but I think I need to do it just to cast a spell. Okay, well. I guess it's just hat. You know what? This might be bad, but let's get some stats on the fairy. They got double husky. I guess they are Icarus, so they're up in XP. Take some damage. I swear we had didn't we just have this exact shop? Wondering if he might play first and then start casting when knocked out. I guess, yeah, there's no reason he couldn't, right? Just to see. Just to see where he places or whatever. And then, if he were to make top 8, he could, his spot could just be handed down. We're just taking Husky just for some stats. I really want the XP this turn. I don't think I'm going to get it. We are not going to get the XP, unfortunately. All right, we're just going to double spell just for a couple extra stats. We're locking the other Husky just for stats. Metaphor, of course, found book and all kinds of spell stuff. And we lose another one. XP one time, maybe. Like, I know you don't like to cooperate with me for some reason these days, game, but I mean, I want this triple, I think. What am I selling? These two? Then I'm down to 5 characters. Like, this, I mean, not that this is really doing much. This would give us a pretty decent power spike, and it could be a treasure that matters, so I think I'm gonna go for it. I want Pirate Map, but also I think I have to take the Hunter's Talisman at 12 HP. Should I cast the spell first? Screw it. Just how we drew it up. This should pop into a 7 and we get to keep our pirate map. And that means that we can just take this 5. Do we want to take this 5 though? So we get a 7. You're not convinced a random 7 is better than random 6? I think it is. I mean, the hits on 7, on average, I think are much higher. There are some level 6s that I probably would rather over a lot of 7s, like Drumroll or maybe Magic Scarf, but I think on average, you're going to get a way better hit on 7. I think Holy Grail is a fantastic hit here. I'm going to roll. I don't know about this, but I kind of want to take the Kleck. I need to take something. I can't spend too many rolls, although I do have 11 gold left. I do kind of want to get more XP. You would have taken Sage and hoped for Reflector? Yeah. That could be right. I mean, really, I'm just hoping, I was really hoping for Haymaker. I'm just gonna take this. Just a good chunk of stats. And then we're gonna take Golden Mimic. And then we're also gonna take this. And then we're gonna choose a hero next time, I guess. Anyways, Golden Mimic is gonna let us choose four things with Holy Grail. You'll see that it's not popped. We really just don't want to take anything else, honestly. I think it's just XP that we want. And Silver Arrow, Scabbard. I mean, Silver Arrow and Scabbard for sure, but like the hits on 7 though, like Holy Grail or like Fairy Tale or like Once Ugly Duckling. The hits are so much better though, on average. Like there's a fair amount of whiffs on 6 too, like Hurricane or like even Orchestra is only okay for like 3 turns. I guess I'm taking this. Basically just rolling for XP here. Cause I need to get I could take a golden haymaker. Never mind. I only have one left on 6, but it's fine. Yeah, let's actually get out of hero mask. Doubled Holly's gold is pretty good. Yeah, we definitely want Spirit by Giga Chad. So what's up, 6-4 Ninja? I don't know. Like I said, I think the average power level on 7 is way higher than the average power level on 6. There are like incredible hits on 6 that are probably better than most of the 7s. But you're just more likely to get a really good hit on 7. Yep. We go to 6. Could take Nero. I don't think so, though. Hurricane is not on 7. True. Exactly. I mean, also, like, Merlin's Lessons doesn't do anything if you're not mages. The stat treasures on 6 fall off so, so fast. Also, what's up, Trons? Hope you're well. Good to see ya. I need to hit a 6 right now, though. A 6 that I want. So we're kind of just doom rolling. Yeah, that's it. Drum roll. Boom. Alright, and that's game. So everyone else can pack it up. Sometimes Hurricane wins the game. I mean, I've played a lot of games and I don't think I've ever had Hurricane win me the game. I've taken Hurricane hoping that it helps me, but I don't think it's ever made a difference for me. Like the use case for Hurricane feels incredibly narrow. I'm not gonna bother with that. We are gonna bother with this. Yeah, on 5.0, like, yeah, you can't build into it. It just doesn't really do anything, right? You either want your Fisher King treasure to give you a bunch of tempo or direction, so Two of you. Well, that's, I mean, that's two more than me, so that's impressive. I think we're good on Matt now. I'm happy to take a good boy. I'll take a Nero as well. Still got a couple of dead pieces on our board, but we're in a pretty good spot with the double drum rolls. We just need to switch heroes into Aladdin now. Can be ruthless in the 1v1. Yeah, I suppose it depends on the matchup, right? Your opponent has to really be relying on ranged. It's really good against like Kiv. Like the Kiv matchup, it does shut down Kiv pretty effectively. So I haven't actually used Hurricane recently. I guess, yeah, it's pretty good against Angels. Yeah, that's fair. So maybe I'm just not I haven't used it enough in recent patches. I don't even know if this is necessarily where we want to be. Maybe we're out of Nero eventually. I'm gonna lock the Ascendants. We don't really need too many sixes. Robbie's Angels have make it hard sometimes though, because you need more units than them, but yeah. Alright, thanks again for the raid, Fiesta. Appreciate it. Good luck to you as well. Makes it harder for them to grind you down if you're ahead. Yeah. Yeah, so they're not getting like free attacks basically. I just want to get more good boys on the board, so I think this is what we do. Bluffs, unfortunately for them, don't stand a chance here. They're just not going to win the stat war. Yeah, the Archangel. I mean the Archangel, usually they've got the revives even before the Archangels get to attack, especially if the commanders are up front and are attacking into things and dying. Then they attack in and die, and then revive, and then attack in and die. I don't know if they get to attack again that way. Does it count as a new unit? I feel like I've seen the order keep going, but I'm not sure if it's when they attack in. Or if it's them attacking in with Unyielding and then being attacked and reviving. Alright, and Meta is the last person standing. Oh, Meta does have a lamp that popped though. So it's certainly not over. Yeah, that's a double diamond. I almost want to do this. No. No, it's like this. I mean, I could summon the second Nero here instead of this, but this is probably better. You want to cut Nero? Nero puts so many stats on the good boys, though. I mean, we just try and put the nail in the coffin with the spell, right? We get another shot here. I think we change heroes. Four good boys is so much. That's true. But I guess it depends on how much scam that they have. Like, I like having as many ranged characters as I can. Especially when they probably know that they have to scam. Wait, did Lamp not pop? Wait, what? Lamp should be popped. Did he re-roll it? Or did he quit before it popped? Alright. Alright, anyways, we had like one of the most insane turns of my entire playing career here. In FTF, at least. Like the sequence that we hit with that Fisher King turn was kind of insane. It just kind of all lined up perfectly. Thank you for the GG though. We high rolled on him. We got high rolled on and we high rolled him back. Well, not horse thief, but just the general populace, I guess. That put us up a couple spots. Also, I brought my average down from 2.6 to 2.5. I feel like when you don't have the Carol emote, it's a great emote, hey? The smiling sprout. I like how the first part got cut off. Looks like Oppa's hiding behind the text. Yeah, I mean Carol designed an emote for me as well. For back in the SBB days that I cherish fondly. She made this one as well. Cuz I hated eggs in SBB with a fiery passion. And Forky hates eggs in this game with the same passion. Yeah, it's so much bigger than everything, you know? It was made you feel like you were losing from the get-go. That's actually, I saw some people like complaining about ties in this game, but actually I feel like I'd rather see a lot of ties than just feel like I'm losing right from the beginning of the game. If I feel like I'm losing every fight, like I don't know, I feel like it's easier to get tilted. Whereas, like, if you're at least if you're competing and getting ties, like, you still, I mean, the games last a little bit longer, but you just like you take way bigger chunks of damage later, which arguably also feels bad. But But feeling like I'm losing from the outset just because somebody else bought an egg feels bad. That's why you don't play zero attack heroes. Yeah, that's why I'm pretty hesitant to pick a lot of zero attack heroes. There are some that are worth it. I think Demeter is worth it. You probably take a hit or two, but like I think the stats you get actually they start to add up pretty quickly. Yeah, I like that it's not on level 2 at least. Do we just do another Sinbad game? The rest of these are kind of whatever. I haven't played Gambler in a while, though. Yo, Greed. Enjoy that 3, and thank you so much. Appreciate it. Odin's not a terrible zero attack hero, because you can get the hero attack spell right away. For cheap.
Right to jam, right away.
I think I want to do Sinbad again, though. Kind of like doubling up early treasures. Take this and lock this. It's likely that they're going to take a parrot on turn one. Just came in to look for a tool. And you checked my stream for a tool? Oh my god, this sucks. Is it Goose? Oh, it has to be Goose, otherwise we're just, yeah. I'm still locking this to take two next turn, but... But yeah, appreciate you stopping in anyways, Greed. Yeah, I always have something lurking as well. A lot of times it's SBB or FTF. I gotta take a roll. I'd like to get a pair. There are no pairs. This is also a really bad shop. Do we greed here? No. That could not have gone worse. I don't think I'd take the other goose. As much as I want a triple early. Man, why is everything already too big to slay? Taking a billion damage early here. Doesn't feel great. So we don't take the golden damage, I guess. This is a pair that we can take. It's like okay with the sword squire. It's not ideal. Either that or what, egg? I think I just sell this immediately. No, can't cast the spell even. It would ruin me. Which means it's probably going to get cast against us. No, but they do get the perfect attack. At least we don't take damage. Did we have two gold? It was the two gold sword, wasn't it? I probably would have, but I thought that was the two gold sword. I guess I'm taking Kappa. It's like 3.1 already feels too late, but it's like one of the few things that actually works well with these cats early here. Okay, yeah, no, I should have taken the sword. I thought it was the 2G sword, I just, yeah. Brain's fried, I guess. Alright, getting the triple there is nice. And we get, we could go immutable idol here. Or we could go double silent bell, that's also pretty good. The double immutable idol, like at 14-14 is like real though. Silent bell with the two cat summons. Plus 8, plus 6. Also pretty good. Actually really tough. Yeah, I mean, Pirate Cook's gonna be good if we can find crew members and duelists. It's a pretty big consti already. I don't even want this. Ocean Crab's pretty good. I think I'm taking this Pirate Cook actually as well. It's another three pair. I think we want to prioritize scaling on the Kappa. Like, I feel like we're pretty strong. And if we can get this Kappa nice and big, then it can core fusion onto something later. Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of Bell myself, but the double Bell is a huge amount of stats. It'd be cool to see more things that that care about cats though. I guess I'd do this. Plus five to the board, is that... That's better than just a second one of these, right? getting pretty good scaling. That is a 3 triple. Simple dagger, probably, over Seer Sphere. Just because of what we're doing here. Wow, actually, I want 3 things from this shop. I think I take the triple first. I'm gonna take the other crew member as well. Power bag over catalyst. Yeah, I think so. I mean, the three pairs is kind of nice to have, but do I want another one of these? I guess I can't really sell for it. Dropped a gallon of milk you just opened and the jug split on the kitchen floor. Oh no, Kev, that sucks so mad, so much. So sorry. Also, they had a golden dwarf. They knew you'd the hell out of something. Yeah, no, that's absolutely brutal. I'm so sorry. Not only do you have to go get more milk, but that's a huge mess. Yeah, if you don't clean it, it's gonna smell, so. If you don't clean it perfectly. What's up, Daryl? Good to see ya. Hope you've been well. Not taking this, but I think we're leaning into cats. Or no, I'm gonna take Haymaker. If it's there, I'm gonna take it. I think you have to. Also, I don't think we're gonna find catnips, just because, you know, game cooperating. Okay, there it is. Just to prove me wrong. Also, we only summoned one cat last turn, so this funny cat, not doing much. We're out of this. For this. I think it's like this. Doing okay? Well, good. Good to hear that you're doing okay. On medium Thursday. We're all medium on medium Thursday. Except for Kivial, who's having a bad Thursday. That's a lot of Romeos and Juliets. We get a tie. XP would be really nice. I will take a Narc. And we'll take another Haymaker. What are we out of, though? Also Milk Woman. I guess we just don't play it, because I don't think we can cut the Kappa, right? Like, it's so big. We might have to cut it next turn, though. because we want to play both haymakers, of course, with the milk woman. I think we're just out of Bell next turn. Maybe we should be out of Bell this turn. So many stats, though. No. The haymaker over bottle. I mean, just to get food stats on, maybe. Bottle's pretty big, though. Like, I mean, summoning the funny cat to give our board +5/+5 is about the same amount of stats, but getting these food stats online to start retaining, I think, is something that is valuable. Good new you on the young Kappa. Probably not worth it. It's a little bit late. I am going to lock that. And get out of our Bell. I guess we don't care too much about catnip anymore. Well, like, it's not bad, because we're going to get these food stats here. I don't know, kind of hard to say. Knockout Dino. Really hoping for Divine Messenger here, but I think it's just Elemental Swords. I don't think we're going to bother with the Duelist. Possible that the crew member chain just, like, doesn't matter anymore either. Well, I mean, we're still getting... No, it's a lot of stats. Interesting. Could be Monkey. Summoning Monkey here would be a fair amount of attack on the board. It's not getting the initial food stats from the haymakers if we summon it, though. Gets a lot better if we get, like, a Doppelganger Diamond, but we're kind of a ways out from that. I think I hold off. Phoenix is an option. I'm not a huge fan of Phoenix, to be honest. I think it's fine, but I'm not excited by it. Alright, we're just out of the crew members. That is a lamp. Wait, why do you have a lamp with no... What is happening? That's super annoying. Yeah, they got lamp that turn. That is concerning for sure. It's... It was 6.0. Oh, Divine Messenger, I don't want Gwyn. I don't think we want to waste that mana on one food stat. Angelic Commander, maybe? Also a double entrance item. If the Haymakers were upgraded, one of the Haymakers was upgraded, I'd probably just buy the item. There's Herding Dog, which, like, if I had the gold, I would probably sell for it. But I don't think I have six things I can sell. And I'm not gonna lock it. Flying item is pretty obnoxious. The gold Ned Miri just, like, let them kind of do, or kind of build into them this super early, so. Wow, down to one. Are we really gonna get a fifth here? Pirate map, Hunter's Talisman. Okay, now give me one of those crew member triples that you've been trying to push on me here. Ads? Wait, stream ads or the ads in your... Did you get Cerveza Crystal ad? That'd be kind of funny. Oh, this is big. The Gorilla song or the Cerveza Crystal song? I guess we're just going Scabbard and praying to God. What is the name of the song? I think it's Fire Coming Out of Monkey's Head. Nah, we're just dead here, aren't we? No, we survived, let's go! Song goes like, what? Wait, what? It's fire coming out of a monkey's head, yeah. Right, then the Cerveza crystal went off? Okay. Nice. That's awesome. I really want to find an Archangel. I think I'm going to pass these by and just try and find... well, it's not Archangel, but... It's not nothing either. Although, we're going to get scammed. Ugh. This is not going to go well. Because we're just going to, I mean, we're just going to lose. Oh, I guess we're only going to lose one angel. Okay, or we lose neither angel. I'm fine with that as well. Now we just need to hit. Oh, they're gonna get to attack first. We should be fine here, though. Yeah. Okay. that sounds like a perfectly stitched stitched Cerveza crystal, like it was put there by whoever did it for Star Wars themselves. It's amazing. Give me food. Can't afford the entrance. There's a good boy, but like... I don't think I can... I get a lot of stats though. It's like 200. But if we can get any slaves with these, then it's really, really good. Ugh, so close. Alright, once again, we just pray for survival. We gotta get one of these sleighs. Alright, we get at least one sleigh. And they don't take out our milkwoman, which is very important. Never mind, it doesn't matter. Man, getting a fourth in this game feels fucking abysmal. I mean, I guess I needed to find the Archangel for this to even be worth it. I needed to find, like, Good Boy or something, yeah, but no. Fifth of this is, or fourth of this is, a travesty. Yeah, I don't think it would come. It wouldn't come through on the clip because the music wouldn't come through. I don't think. Another long queue. Again, I guess like just nobody's playing right now or what? Let's see, Sundy, Hercules, Treasure Ham. These are all pretty solid heroes. If I had to pick one of these tomorrow, what would it be? I do like Herc. I think it might be Guan Yin. I think Guan Yin probably is the most consistent. And like getting access to guaranteed treasures, I should have confirmed. Alright, we got it anyways. Getting access to guaranteed treasures anyways is really, really valuable. Yeah, for sure. It is a good pool. You could pretty much pick anyone and be relatively happy. I think especially in like in the games where like top four equity is like much higher than on like ladder, something like Hercules or Sisyphus is worth looking at. Cause yeah, like the drop off in points between fourth and fifth is pretty large. Also, I think Toy Dino is going to be a really premium pick for like high tempo lobbies like that. Don't think I flipped this over, but I might just take it. Take the pair. Okay, we do flip it over. little bit of damage to Fisher King. Important. Important to bully Fisher King. I think I like farming tools out of here, actually. Over magnifying glass and tower. I actually think farming tools is pretty underrated as a treasure. Also take a 5 power chameleon. I don't hate that. Quanian tempo is solid. Yeah, yeah, for sure. And also, like there's a fair amount of games where you just hit treasure map on 4, and even if you don't get a treasure, or on 5, and then even if you don't get a treasure, all of level 5, you can, I'm gonna lock this and just expect the high roll here. Yeah, you can just get a level 7 treasure just from Guanyin herself. All right, well, of course they get their chameleon slay, but I get to, I'm kindly told to leave or something. I just want Puck here. I want the farmer units. Do I just roll or do I take one of these? It's not great. I could take this pair, I guess. Like it's not something you need to pair up Owl before 3. Well, I just kind of misclicked. It's fine. Let's do this. I'll probably hit the egg, but... Two out of three. Okay. I guess I'm gonna take this just as a speculation. And our speculation kind of pays off immediately. I mean, obviously we want to find this earlier, but better late than never, I suppose. I think we continue to pick them up. Like, starting with 15-15 food stats is pretty good. It's probably Mimic, right? Hat's also not bad. Now this shop is a great example of why level 4 is such a mess. There are 5 level 4 units and not a single one is appealing. Like, even slightly. I think I'm taking XP. Means I can't take this. Yeah, Mimic for the 4 would be nice. I mean, depending on what the 4 ends up being, I guess. Not being able to cast this is unfortunate, though. There's no way 7 power. I mean, it might slay something on that board, but probably not from position 2. I will take another Dachshund, though. I think we take this just for the extra stats and skip. Same deal here. Chrono Crystal is nice, but we're at 30, so. That's true, we don't get value out of Mimic from Crystal. Which, like, yeah, I don't know. I don't know if that's necessarily worth like focusing on, though. Okay, well, we got Haymaker. Never taking another Dachshund. I could just go to 6. Is that better than just like trying to find more Haymakers? I'm gonna take it. I will take a chair. Just for fun. I hope that this is enough to not take damage this turn. Oh, it is. It does factor in your level. So yeah, true. Fair enough. I don't know why. I just thought it was just like the static specific treasures that you got. But yeah, going to 6 is definitely the play here. Then I think Hero Mask, Crescent Blade. Probably Hero Mask. Crescent Blade is like kind of cute with the Angelic Commander, but I think this just offers us more power overall. I think I'm taking Freya. I like Phantom as well, but probably just take here or herding dog. Right. I'll be honest, I completely just missed the baby mimic again. Just completely forgot about it. Very good at this game. I guess I would have just skipped then, if that were the choice. Is Phantom three heroes? Mask can get it to three. Okay. Weird. That doesn't. Like, I thought Hero Mask, you just got extra choices. I didn't think that it would actually. Phantom plus Helix is also three, but that's hard. Okay. I guess it just copies what? Hero slot? Or the. That's weird. Doesn't necessarily make a lot of sense to me. Yeah, we're just rolling. You're already Phantom, they give you another one, so you get three. Huh. Okay. I'll have to keep that in mind. Seen four once, but never five, okay. Even four is pretty silly. Wow, they really held off on their treasures for a while, so good for them. I think I want this spell too. Do I want this shard? No, I don't think so. I can't really do Celestial Harp either. Is this just a skip? I think it's just a skip. Like, shard can be okay, I guess. But if I see like a pair that I want, then that could be awkward. No, it's gotta be better than four gold. Yeah, we can replace the farming tools though. This will give us like a pretty big power spike if we just find basically anything. Or we might just get four gold to start next turn, which would let us roll down and find more things as well. Double Cat Choir. They're not small. It'll just be awkward if we find like another Angelic Commander, and then we won't be able to take it. We might just take it anyway, but. It's cute that they're trying to make Cat Altar work. I wish the stats on Cat Alter were relevant too. Okay, it was Divine Messenger for sure. And I think we also take a Gwyn. Upgraded Gwyn is pretty strong. Then we get another triple next turn. Do we do Pirate Safe? Or maybe you just skip here, actually. So I want a six. I want Drumroll. Or I could just get a seven next turn, which could be okay, but no, I just want this turn. Yeah, could be worse. Could certainly be worse. Double Angel? No, I think the double Golden Good Boy is probably better. Honestly, the Angel probably goes pretty quick. I think just getting multiple good boys on our front row is going to be our line here. Although, like, it's possible we could pick up like an Archangel just to have the potential. I do like this too. Don't like this really. Like with the Divine Messenger, this is a lot of stats. We've already got our chair to protect ourselves too. Freya is now all used up, so yeah, no, it doesn't matter with the Divine Messenger. Might be worth just ascendancing the Milk Woman. Another lamp. Man, we've seen so many lamps these past couple lobbies. Do you want to lead with the bigger one? I mean, yeah, we could do that. It does get bigger. That's right. Kill one good boy. Challenge level impossible. We're not bothering with the fisherman. We don't have nearly enough food stats, and like we're just a boost comp from here. Oh, that was a Milk Woman. I just skipped over a Milk Woman. That was bad. Ring and Last Shop? Oh, like an Alliance Band? Yeah, I guess I should be looking over those as well. I mean, I probably just want... You liked Core Fusion? What would you Core Fusion on this board? Like, we don't really have anything that's big enough to fusion. Haymaker onto Milk Woman, I suppose, yeah. That would ruin our retain, though. I mean, it would nerf our retain by quite a bit. I guess that would be for like a last fight kind of deal. Again. Can't even kill a single good boy. I already sold the other one. This is pretty big. We could monkey. We could just cut this and then Doppel the monkey. I'll put a ton of stats on the good boys. Also protects our back line if they decide to take a flying item. Speaking of flying items, I don't think we need it. We just go over top of them, as long as they don't disrupt us. And yeah, even the Haymaker Core Fusion is still not incredibly impressive. Like our retain or preserve has just been really bad, because all we have is the one Haymaker. So like I'm still not even gonna bother with that. Yeah, 7-4. And yeah, we just weren't retaining enough food stats. Yeah, they don't even upgrade their Cat Queen, so they're trying to fight an unfair war with a very fair comp. There we go. Didn't even need to upgrade our Milkwoman. Oh, we're in top 15 now. We go again. All right, while we're queuing, I'm just gonna go and refill my water. It should take like 3 minutes, so. Also, feel free to snipe anyone, as always. Okay, who do we like here? This is a much more mediocre hero selection. For me, I think it's between Midas and Cheshire Cat. Just not a big fan of Match Girl. I know some other people rate her pretty highly. I think maybe it's a Midas game. Cheshire Cat buff kind of wears off pretty quickly. Like, you do get decent stats on, like, level 2 and even into 3, but... Oh. Once again. Ran out of time. So we're gonna get a random hero. Oh, no. Oh, so do we not need to confirm anymore? That'd be nice. Take a roll. I think I'm taking this. It's so many stats if we just combine it. And flip it over. Interesting. They use a mana there? Two gold, 4/3 range is probably worth taking. Yo, what's up, Greed? Welcome back. Car fixed. Now you can play some video games? Hell yeah. Cedar and car, gotcha. Ooh, the no hero attack on Odin. Punished. Too late for Owl, unfortunately. This is not exactly exciting either. Just farm boy? A little golden damage to the lobby here. Already bullying people. Ooh, that is actually kind of spicy. They're definitely going for it. I think I lock this. So big. We kind of burn a gold here, but I think that's fine. We can get like 2 slays off this golden fox, that'd be fantastic. Of course we managed to just not get a single slay though, because that's my entire life. It feels. How do we not slay with 12 power on position 5 though, after getting the attack? It boggles the mind. Just how bad slay is, or and there's an empty board there, so we get 0 slay from that as well. That's awesome. Take one more roll. Okay, so they did manage to put something on their board. After being AFK, clearly. Man, what a disappointment. We might just new you next turn, or this turn as well. And then just like pray that we roll into a new you, or into a new you, or Morphalot into a new you, maybe? Oh, Well, I mean, that's a good hit for one turn. Knew you. Damn. Like, I don't think there's ever a world where we end up as fluffs, but I might as well take one, just as speculation here. Maybe we just get like a couple shops just chock full of fluffs. We could end up there, maybe. I think that's the best option out of this shop anyways. Take one roll. I don't mind crab. I mean, I guess I should take crab. I also kind of want this, but yeah, I'm taking this as well. If I hadn't taken this, I could have cast XP this turn. Do I lock the XP? I might. Skipping over 4 to 5, or getting to 5 as soon as possible, I think is very valuable. So, I think this is what we're gonna do. Oh, they really have a theme going on here. It's a lot of Consti plus Immutable Idol. Pretty good. Only I could get to this as well. I have to sell 2 things. I could sell these 2. Now let me buy this as well. Does that give me enough of a boost to be worth it here? To go down to 5? They just tripled Sprout and they're all in on it, eh? No, I can't take this, but what I can take and what I feel like I need to take is this spider. Yeah. Yeah, we're gonna spider him. Unfortunately, well, actually, I think we do want to do this. They attack here, then we get to slay, maybe, just on the off chance. I know it's not super likely, but crab front to make it 50-50. Well, I mean, they had to attack and do it eventually, but yeah, maybe. Do I just scam? Is that who we are? I think we don't immediately scam. This is worth upgrading because it gets it up to 6 power. We could just succubus here. Although I think it's Galahad. Actually. Speaking of Galahad, I guess that means we take the Kiv. I don't think we lock for it though. It's like Haymaker is still so absurdly good with the golden milk woman. Even though we got the Kiv in chat. Which does make me want to take it 50% more. But it's not zero. I mean, I just said I wanted to take it. Why would it be zero? Kiv's a great unit. You're a great unit. I've got at least 2 videos featuring you prominently on my YouTube. Going to 6 is like pretty tempting. I think we're just gonna do it. And we get somewhat rewarded. Now we really want that Kiv, actually. Come back, Kiv. Monkey into summoner. Probably too cute to speculate on. If there was a duelist in this shop, I would be a little bit more inclined. But also, like, we need to get food. Like, this dachshund can only put food stats on Milkwoman for so long, or have it be relevant for so long. We need either a haymaker or something. Or another avenue. We are indeed. We're Midasin. Terrible level 6 shop. Also a terrible level 6 shop. I mean, we could take the demon. We're going to 6 next turn anyways, so like we don't have to, but we could just be scam. There's a streamer. Oh yeah, actually I saw that challenge. I was actually considering trying it. I think it might be fun. But I mean, it's like Women's History Month, right? So there's a challenge going around to speedrun and see how fast you can name 100 women. 100 Googleable women. So not just like people you know, like your friends and family or whatever. I really just don't like High Demon at all. Jackie Chan. Yeah. Minus one. I'm going to take this as a speculation. I don't know if they have to have a Wikipedia article, but I think, like, you just have to be able to Google them, and they have to be a person. And not a fictional character. Because, I mean, fictional characters have Wikipedia, yeah. The criteria is they can't be fictional characters. They have to be women in the real world with some significance. Alright. We're frankin' beans in. We don't cast a combat spell here, right? I don't think we need to. How much does this matter? Like, almost not at all, right? I think this is still the setup we want, right? I'm like tempted to play this. I mean, I could just do this. It's not great. Gives us one more evil though. We got what? 6 here? 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. That evens out the number. So this might be the play actually. Kind of awkward that they know the way this works though, because we don't really want them attacking into Galahad first, but I suppose I could have left this in 5, moved this to 4, and then put Galahad here and had Arthur there. That's certainly valid as well. I don't think we want the mirror, not at this stage. It's too late for Haymaker. We've already kind of found our path, and it's unfortunately not in the same direction. Dying Breath item is something I want. Do I just lock here? I might just lock for the Dying Breath item. As soon as you start playing something, you get asked to meet for dinner. Sorry, Greed. Too important of a person, I guess. Thanks for the good luck, Reed. Hope you have a good dinner. I appreciate the lurk. It must have a pretty big summon chain in there. Have such a small board. Alright, it is not as big as I assumed. Ooh, they get left at one though. Succubus. Succubus, pretty good. I think we just take the succubus. Don't think we want another archdemon. We're finally out of this now. I think we swap these, because I want the succubus to attack first to do as much damage to the board as possible, and then BLT cleans up better. We do need... I guess we just play this instead of the Arthur then. Even with shields? Right, shield does negate those succubus, right? Yeah, good call. We didn't see any flying items, right? Not yet. A pretty good selection of scam. Wasn't quite enough to take him down, but we're definitely changing heroes. Phantom? Phantom's the only one that I really want here. We're at 23. I don't know if five rounds is gonna go to 20. Maybe it's just Tinkerbell actually. Cause I don't think the lobby lasts five more rounds. Dionysus is all. I think it's Tinkerbell. Well, I mean, you can also cast another entrance before the timer's up for Phantom, right? So that's something. I do want this. I think I'm locking for it. And I'm pretty happy to just take another spider here. Yeah, I'm pretty sure swapping heroes gives you two, because I think Swiftwolf was saying, I saw Swiftwolf saying something about it just cares if you're casting the spell, and it gives you your two slots. Of course they are fire maging. I don't think they were stealth when I looked last. God damn it. Ugh, stealth. Okay, we just need a chair. There's a chair. Got a Cats. Cats and stealth, like literally the worst matchup for Scam. So that's awesome. Like, we don't have the stats to deal with this, even. Yeah. I mean, we need to get BLT up to 6 power somehow. But the wings will be nice. Might just be a third here. Although, like, I mean, we probably lose this fight. Hopefully we don't die. And then, maybe we get the ghost fight, and then potentially, one of them knocks the other out. That's a pretty good hit. I mean, they still have this duelist though, which is a problem. Yeah. Yeah, the full board. Ghost fight now. I don't even know if we beat this board. Finally done making and eating dinner. Nice. How was it? How are the mashed potatoes? Succubus Kiss follows normal attack rules. Frontline if possible. Like against the cats, you mean? We don't have enough time. We're just taking a treasure. Not a good one. Ended up being part of sort of like a potato soup because you blended for too long. Oh, okay. Yeah, I don't even blend my potatoes. I just get a masher. I mash them up a little bit, and then I just like throw some like butter or something, or even like what do you call it? Like broth, like any kind of like liquid, anyways, and then just whip them with a fork, and then yeah, they end up coming out pretty good usually. That's more common in the US, yeah. Your mashed potatoes are much creamier. Okay. I mean, I've seen people like whip their mashed potatoes, like that's also very good. But yeah, I don't mind the like a sort of a chunkier potato, I guess. All right, cool. Neither of them died because why would they? Why would they, right? Also, they hit drum roll. You know? I don't know if this matters ever, but... I don't think I take another one of these. I don't think it matters. I think I'd rather just cast, like, a Cersei's Cup or something. Oh, there's another wolf there. Yeah, that would have been good. Yeah, there's no chance we're ever gonna get that second attack. Hard to envision combat going better for them here. Pretty disappointing third, to be honest. Yeah, I mean, we're not losing MMR at least. Oh, we're almost at 200 wins. Could run Minus back, or we could play Hercules. Those are the only two that I really want here. Like, maybe I'm not respecting Artemis enough, but... probably Herc. Oh no, your heroes are bad? Oh, that sucks. I mean, I guess that's good for me if you're sniping. I do want this. I don't want to take too much damage, though. Good luck, Carol. This is 3 damage. That's so much. I want to start with like an owl or a sprout on Herc, so maybe I should have just rolled. Ugh, trash, not good. Too late for Owl already. Guess it's just the Elaine. Feels extremely bad. Not a good shot. I think maybe it's Barret. What else do we look for? Like, what else do we want? I mean, just like Frog would have been nice, I guess. There are no frogs here, though. I'm gonna frontline everything. It's Ares. Yeah, that was dumb. That was very dumb. I mean, farmer. It's not like ideal for Herc, but it's just ideal in general, I guess. Things with 4 HP for the front. Too late for a fluff, right? Even with the sheep. Well, if I'd taken that first one, then this one would be a lot more enticing. Might just be egg here. I don't think we can roll again, so we just take this, and then we get one more egg. I think just anything with 4 HP for the front. Perfect hit. Hey, we don't lose an egg. Let's go. Even through their rune here. Or I guess no, that doesn't even have stats. Never mind. That's nothing. Oh, we've seen so many of these. Oh, against the Ares, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I didn't even register that I was fighting Ares. I wish I knew that I was going to get a crew member in the next shop. I would probably take that. I'm going to take one more roll, though. Ugh. You know? Punished. Okay. We'll take this. I'll just take the aura, I guess. Almost made a bad play. I don't think I... Do I just take the... I guess I do take the husky, right? Pretty large. We will lock that. Make sure we go first with our 3 power range. It's effectively 6 power, so... There's that. I could do this, I guess. And then maybe we actually get to attack for 7? Yeah, okay. Hey, we got the attack. And deny their slay. Pretty important to deny their golden poly slay on 4.0. They got like a haymaker. Things go poorly for the rest of their lobby. We could take Magic Bean or Helmet. Or Egg Shrine. Is it ever Egg Shrine? Like, it gives us 6-6 in stats right now. And, like, maybe we can get some permanent stats on the Milk Woman or something. Bean is okay if we don't get another treasure until 5. Which, like, we might not. Yeah, okay, I'll take Bean. Try my net pair. Kind of interesting. We can get up to 7 comfortably here, but we can't quite get them both. I think it's one more roll. Punished. Keep our health high. Ooh, that'd have been a pretty good egg shrine turn. One more food here, I guess. Actually, I do kind of want this Slamulet. Just in case. Like, I mean, I don't think we end up in Slay, but... there could be a world, you know? Pretty big board over there, though. Kind of scary. They probably had another treasure this turn. They do have a pair. Hopefully it's nothing too scary. Okay, they didn't hit it. Wow. 1 HP. Alright, well, I guess we're food. Doomroll for Haymakers, even if you saw Klex, Siren, and Nocturne in the same shop? Yeah, I mean, 5.0 maybe, but I don't know. I've made Slay work to a medium degree. And especially on Hercules, like, if you get some Slay going, and then you pop your Hercules power, like, you get a pretty significant spike. But yeah. I don't think you're wrong. Welp. The duelist is also a consideration there. In fact, maybe duelist is even better. Than just getting the haymaker buff. If I see another duelist, I might take it. Fishing rod. They do have a haymaker. Let's go for the Hail Mary, I guess. Second haymaker. That's huge. Third haymaker. Oh god, it's happening. Actually, I'm out of slamulet. Drumroll. Damn. Magic scarf. I guess it's mage gloves. I like magic scarf for like, but you need Merlins. But I guess it's just mage gloves, yeah. Now we really want the duelist to summon the monkey in. Hey, I mean, we still need a couple turns to really get our food stats rolling, so we are going to be kind of big though, I think. So I'm sorry, Carol. I can imagine, like, if you're not looking at the stream, and you just hear me talk about popping off, the stress that could induce. We didn't hit drum roll, so there's that. I mean, you are quite large yourself. That symbol? Symbol doing some work there. I don't think I take another dachshund. It's a little too late for that. I do want this though. Also, don't think I bother with that. Ooh, core fusion. Ooh, going into the six. Well, no, it had food. No, it had food stats preserved from the haymaker, and so it gives food stats as well. All right, here we go. Yeah, just the preserved ones. Yeah, it's just, I'm pretty sure those are just theoretical food stats anyways. At least I hope so. Not speculating there. I am taking this though. That is huge. And this. We don't even need another one of these. And we will lock that. Stopped yourself from casting the +1/+2 spell in case you hit another demon. You got it. Let's go. Shout out to discipline. Good trigger discipline or whatever. I think I need to swap heroes, because, like, honestly, Perk doesn't do much on this board. Got a Mask into Fisher King, replacing Mask. Makeshift level 6. I mean, yeah, it's basically you're just, you get a free Fisher King, right? Didn't even pop my duelist. Pirate map. I think we get a level 5 treasure before we get a 6. Well, maybe not. Maybe not. Do I want this good boy? I can't lock for it, so I don't think I'd take it. Because I'd rather like cast a food spell if I can this turn. I do want this, though. The preserve for these farmers is just too important not to. Well, it's possible I should have actually shifted these a little bit. You have one fairly large, two fairly large dwarves, but it's not quite enough. Oh no, what do I sell? I think I really want to get this turn. I sell one of these pirate monkeys? I probably shouldn't. I could sell the duelist, I guess, and then just wait and then just try and find another one. Like, that's not. It's not great, but. The most replaceable thing, I think. Thing I can live with for like a turn or two. Live without for a turn or two. I need this other monkey to pop my treasure. And then get the Merlin triple. No, this is the wrong order. I'm gonna take it still. I think we're just gonna fairy tale, I guess. Then we don't get access to any more treasures. I think it's fine. I'm hoping we can close this out. Are you 100% Dedge? I don't know, your board doesn't look bad. You got the drum roll. I mean, I guess you're not really food, but you got the good boys. Good boy putting stats on the Arthurs. Alright, maybe dead. Sorry, Carol. GG. Yeah. I mean, that. I feel like that's how this game goes most of the time. Somebody high rolls. And then it's either you keep pace with them or you die. And it can feel pretty bad. Hey, let's go. Fairy tale closed it out. Food wins again. Who would have thought? Still 15. Gain a whole 15 MMR to get up to 14. What hero power? Exactly. Who needs a hero power? Alright, we can do one more before I'm going to have to take off. I'm going to quickly run to the bathroom while we queue. Be right back. All right, Q still going. All right. Odysseus is really good. Freya's pretty good. Daedalus is pretty good. Brother Gambler's fine. Got better heroes this time. Let's go. I think we're gonna go Odysseus. I think I want to play. I want to get more reps in with Odysseus. I think Odysseus is quite good. You also think it's Odysseus? Well, that's good. Carol on Demeter. Good luck, Carol. But of course, why wouldn't they get two units on turn one? That makes complete sense. We definitely just want more owls before we hit 3.0. Like, we need at least one more owl anyways. Dropping to 25 after losing the first fight is rough. I mean, taking a 1-1 owl, we're kind of open to losing a fight if they play anything with 4 toughness. Oh my god, what is happening? How are we losing 2 fights in a row? That sucks. I hate it. It sucks and I hate it. And punished. Now what? Sure, like that. This sort of counts as an extra attack. Hopefully our level 3 treasures will help us stabilize here. Elox Sprout triple going on to 3 on Demeter. Yeah, I don't think I would. I think I'd wait to triple it up. I guess it's Starcatcher. We take the puck. I kinda wanna take this, but we can take it later. All right, I guess we're just stars or something. Yikes. Yeah, I think eventually you'll find the Sprout triple, and I don't think the level 2 treasures are impactful enough to really feel like you need to do it personally anyways. Ooh, a second puck, okay. Do I do a second one of these? I don't want to. Oh, what's the alternative though? Do we take a roll? I could take this, I guess. It's not the worst thing ever, actually. Yeah, okay. I kind of just, like, put this out of my mind. But, like, plus 2 plus 1 is not... It's not a completely insignificant buff. Actually, I probably should have been supporting the bluebells here, since they... The pucks did actually have a little bit of, stats on them. Probably doesn't matter too much, but... Things could have maybe gone a little bit better. Bottled ship? Yeah, okay. And now I'll take this. One more roll. Is there ever a world where we take another bluebell? No. No, there is not. We just take this. I mean, I've seen good starboards, but they're just so easily counterable. I don't know. I have feelings about stars and hero attack. They just feel tacked on, and the fact that, like, they're just kind of like shoved in the game and they don't really interact with anything else. Not a huge fan, anyways. Magic bean, hat. Is it magic bean? Then we're asking for a 4, although that could be okay. We get a 4 and, like, we get 4 looks at a treasure map, that's probably fine. Not bad. I would like Stargirl. He scales very fast on our board. I also want XP. Even a moth I would take. We're gonna see none of that though. Oh, there's XP. I don't think we win a fight, but... Like, maybe. Maybe. That board doesn't look extremely powerful. We found the Stargirl. You've not won with stars. I've lost to stars. I've not won with stars either myself. Wait, they got a lot bigger than they don't look like they were. That's unfortunate. Demon dog, kind of big, ish. Not big enough though. Do I just take the pair? I don't love this pair at this point on this board. I guess it's just this. Didn't really improve our board much. And this, the Starcatcher scaling is is not going to be enough. Fireballs, several fireballs is not good. And yeah, why not? Why wouldn't they just hit every single mage treasure? Well, I mean, they got Merlin's Tower and Seer's Sphere, but still. They hit all the books. Ruined our board. And got the right attacks. Like, I guess I just take the spider. Because I need to move into scam, if possible. I can't even take this, because I need to pop this next turn. This just doesn't help me. Like, it would be a decent chunk of stats, though. Which is kind of sad. If I don't get offered treasure map, then I guess it doesn't matter. And we don't. Spyglass? No. It's probably power bag over the spell treasures. Just to get stats on the board. Also has 80% preserve, so like the food stats don't disappear super fast. I'm taking that Nocturne, I think. And we're also taking this Chrono Crystal. I guess we're out of the bottled ship for now. Double Nocturne, maybe? Anyone? Unfortunately, I don't think. I don't even know if we get to slay Carol. Carol's a little bit too big here. A little bit too powerful, probably. Yeah, we do kind of need to get the slays. Do I even bother with this Star Child? Like maybe like the volume of stars will be enough. I don't know. There's a high chance I get it. I get what, a slay? I need more than one slay probably. But yeah. Nailed it. Probably the worst possible hits there. Yeah. Continuing. Okay, well, we get a couple Nocturne Slays. That's enough to get a tie, which I'm happy about. Yes, that was a pretty good suck hit. And also me hitting the 1 in 4 to not slay. I kind of want this, but... And another huge... Yeah. I mean, this is just always going to happen. Like, everyone's always... Like, it's so hard to get any amount of slays. just in general. Numbers just get too nuts far too quickly. That's an interesting proposition, though. What if I... do this? Or... which one is it? All right, let's try like that. We immediately get 220 power self-resort. Yeah, okay. Fair enough. Yeah, it's just exchanging or putting. I get to put one extra stat on the board. Yeah, I like it. Oh yeah, we get some slays here. Honestly, these nocturnes are kind of growing. I almost don't want to combine them, but I feel like I need to. I think this is this a skip? Or no, it's Elemental Swords over Power Bag. Yeah. I actually think I'd take another one of these. Oh, well, I can sell this. That's okay. Pretty sure this thing grows very large very quickly. We're not quite big enough to withstand the Tengu Slay, unfortunately. Okay, not ideal, but of course they got Women in the Moon on 5.1 here, or 5.2. That's annoying. It's okay though. I mean, we have Chrono Crystal. Maybe we can survive into a top 4 here. I mean, it's different for sure. Yo, what's up, Spylo? Enjoy that 3. You earned it, bud.
I'm Mr. T and I'm a Night Elf Mohawk.
I guess we're out of Bluebell for now. Although, I kind of like it more than the Puck, to be honest. Bigger as well. Yes, I mean stars, slays I can make work a little bit. Also, what's up, Master T? Hope you're well today. I also hope you're well today as well, Spylo, of course. Hope you're both having a good medium Thursday. Oberon, where are you? All right, not present, unfortunately. Work was obnoxious with Easter coming up. Ah, fair. A lot of Easter brunches or whatever. Pretty bad hit for me there. And the succubus, just the bane of my existence here. Popping my crystal there is kind of rude. What are you gonna do though? I mean, combat probably couldn't have gone worse for me there, but. Do I want a core fusion again? The Star Girl, once again, maybe? Maybe it's Star Child. Maybe a core fusion onto the Star Child again. Or do I core fusion onto the Nocturne? I don't know how many slays I get though. You have an Easter brunch event? It's your largest event of the year. Oh, really? That's surprising. Of course, it's a stealth build. Who has they found the Shadow Cat and the Arthur, or and the Fire Mage. I guess we need to find a chair. Maybe a chair lets us survive. Not that. All right, I think we're just dead. We just get, yeah, and they found the twig of course as well. Instant 3-for-1. Also, I think I ran out of, or I don't know if I had enough gold left over. Disappointing. Really, really bad result. I mean, like, it's stars. Like, they're not gonna do much. Although, like, combats kinda went pretty poorly in a lot of spots. I don't know. We kinda had some stuff going with the Nocturnes, though, but. Yeah, not entirely sure what would have really put us over the top there. Pretty much nothing. Just like we need to find like a bunch of Titania immediately or something. Start of the season for your club. Spent at least 4 hours today shelling and cutting. 25 pounds of boiled eggs, so damn. That sounds tedious, but also delicious. We still hold on to 15th place here.
Not the bears!
Probably our final game before tournament tomorrow. Have I seen Tennessee onions? No, I've never. I don't know what Tennessee onions are. The recipe you posted, all right. What's up, Kirby? What's the tournament schedule? We start at 9 a.m. tomorrow, 9 a.m. Pacific time. And then yeah, I think it's like 3 or 4 rounds, and then there's like a cut, and then there's like three rounds, and then a cut, and then like 2 more rounds, and then another cut. Yeah, I'll probably stream my games. It's with a 5-minute delay. I might do it like without a mic. For the games at least. Just put the music on a little louder or something. Just to dial in as much as possible. But yeah, we have to stream with a 5-minute delay, and I guess there's no real reason not to broadcast at least. All right. I do have to leave though. Unfortunately, normally I'd have to leave at this time on a Friday, but my girlfriend switched her shifts for this week, so tomorrow we're gonna have to do Parks and Rec an hour later. Can you call me on Discord during the tournament? Ask that. I mean, you could call me, I guess. I might mute Discord too, but you can ask the questions. But yeah, for those of you here that are normally participating in our Parks and Rec watch along that we do every Friday, we will be doing it an hour later. I'm gonna throw my YouTube in chat just for anyone here that isn't following me over there already. I'd appreciate a follow. I've got tons of Fairy Tale Fable content. Yeah, it's all cut down, or the time, or the sped up and downtime cut out for your viewing convenience. And yeah, I'd just really appreciate a follow over there. We're kind of stalled out we're kind of plateaued right now, so hopefully eventually some new people find the channel. Thank you for the good luck. Appreciate that, Kirby and Carol. We're going to send a little raid out to someone, of course. What do we want to raid? We could raid Horse Thief. Horse Thief's still playing. We don't get to raid Horse Thief very often. Couldn't do the tournament even if you were high enough elo. You start work at 9? Oh, yeah. Yeah, the fact that it's on a Friday is a little bit unfortunate. Although, I guess you're probably working this weekend, right? With a big event. No, that wouldn't really coincide for you. Horse Thief the Third. Alright. Anyone here that's not already following Horse Thief, make sure you drop him a follow. He's an excellent streamer, super friendly dude. He runs a great stream. I'm a big fan of his. Yeah. Love you too, Spylo. You work 9 to 4 Wednesday through Sunday. Oh, regardless, right? Fair. The Sunday you work 4 a.m. to 4 p.m. Oh man, that's gonna be brutal. Well, good luck this weekend, anyways, Master T. If I don't hear from you, or if... I hope it goes smooth for you, anyways. But yeah, take care, everyone. I hope you all have a fantastic rest of your day, and I will definitely see you tomorrow. Bye bye.